Hello, this is Glenn Howes of Generally Helpful Software. I'm very pleased to introduce our new product, which is a keyboard extension for iOS 8 called Chemistry Keyboard, which is, as the name would imply, a keyboard that I've designed especially for chemists. I myself have a degree in chemistry, although I never use it. I'm a programmer. Yeah, but I do remember my chemistry, and I do remember, you know, having to figure out, oh, how do I do a subscript when I'm doing a reaction? So, for instance, let's say I was doing a reaction like this, and I'm doing chlorine gas, so I need a subscript 2 to indicate the dichlorine. You might think, oh, that was very simple. Well, let me show you how to do it again. I tap on the 2 with my thumb, let's say, and I slide down, I will get a subscript. If I wanted to slide up, I will use a superscript. In practice, it becomes very natural and is very fast. Similarly, maybe I needed a superscript minus. So again, boom, I have a superscript minus. Maybe I want to indicate a certain kind of reaction arrow. Let's just use the common one. And I generate chlorine gas, so I need another minus, superscript minus, and and you'll notice that I'm very rapidly generating superscripts and subscripts for this reaction. And there, it's done. Now, I spent a lot of time trying to figure out, if I were a working chemist, what would I need for this to do? What characters should I generate? Now, one thing is that obviously on a small keyboard, you really don't have a lot of room, and you have to dole things out appropriately. On the other hand, since you don't want to be spending a lot of time switching to other keyboards, so I felt it was important that I make the various chemical elements, at least the common ones, accessible from the keyboard, so you don't have to switch out to another keyboard to type in Fe or something for iron. So if I don't put it somewhere else, I have a whole grid here of chemical elements. They are in alphabetical order. I do not expect people to have memorized a periodic table to figure out that they want, you know, mercury. Now, one other thing about this keyboard is that it knows about elements. So, for instance, if I hit the backspace key, you might think, well, it's going to erase that G. But no, it will erase the entire mercury element, because you probably do not want to erase just a portion of an element. You probably want to erase the whole thing. And you'll find as you back out that it, you know, it jumps right over an element. You know, bam, 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 bam. Now, of course, some elements are very common and show up in chemical equations all the time. So, obviously, you know, carbon is in most chemical compounds, so it has its own key. And oxygen and hydrogen are also, you know, pretty common. So, you can they have their own keys. I felt that the halogens deserve their own little tab. And that certain elements were common enough to be on their own little tab as well. So obviously there's a lot of things going on with nitrogen. So that's it. That's my little app. You'll see that it's got a lot. It makes accessible a lot of Unicode characters that would be otherwise be hard to get to, that are I felt were useful to the working chemist. My sister tells me it's also useful to people like patent attorneys and people you wouldn't otherwise think of, who need to go out and write an occasional chemical formula. So it's in the App Store. It's $3. It's a nice app. I mean, I'm a pretty good programmer, and I hope you'll enjoy it. This is Glenn Howes, Generally Helpful Software, and the product is Chemistry Keyboard. Thank you.